Shalom, damn it! It's 11 o'clock at night and time for Dave's Gone By, a comedy talk show on AM 1240 WGBB Freeport. It's not the best show on the radio, but let's face it, do you really deserve the best? No, so sit back and settle.
When a man is born, he's born with the foreskin. But the complete man is to be without the foreskin.
Greetings from Long Island, where every highway is a sunrise. It's time for Dave's Gone By, an hour of comedy, talk, and music brought to you by Total Theater, with your host, Dave Lefkowitz. You've never heard anything like it, so sit back, relax, squeal if you must. Here's the host of Dave's Gone By, Dave!
Tropical hot dog night! Like two flamingos in a fruit fight! Every color of day, whirling around at night.
Well, there goes the Daverhood. Welcome, welcome, everyone, one and all, on this cold, what a strange weekend it has been, weather-wise, where I was walking around New York City overdressed on Saturday. It was like sunny and 70-something degrees, and then a day later, we all know how it was today. It was like that blustery, awful wind. And now I think the winds have died down, but it is still kind of cold. But hope that you had a good weekend, had a rather busy one, had a busy week. But this is the cherry on the top of the Sunday that is my week. Unfortunately, usually my Sundays are made of mud and excrement. But whatever they're made of, this is the crowning part of it. This is the happy part of my time here, because I'm doing my radio show, Dave's Gone By, an hour of comedy, talk radio, music, interviews, all sorts of stuff. It's the joy of what I do here. I've been doing it since October of 2002. This is our 297th episode on this Sunday night, November 16th, 2008, and we're calling it Torna a Sorrentino. No, not Torna a Sorrento, but Torna a Sorrentino, because our special guest, whom we're going to be calling in just a few minutes, is a master of impressions and comedy, and his name is Stephen Sorrentino. He's going to be playing locally in a week or so, but he's been in Vegas for quite a bit, so he's got some mileage on him, and I've seen his stuff on YouTube. You can go to his website, and he's actually pretty funny. I hate when I sometimes have guests on here and I want to direct them to go see a sample of their work, and then you click on it and it's like, oh, you know, that's not so good. Or I get the occasional musician on, and they kind of sound okay in studio, but then you go looking for their stuff or hearing them on CD, and it's, okay, little bit of a taste factor there. But no, I think you'll be very pleasantly surprised if you go to YouTube or his website. I don't have that one written down, but I'm assuming it's StephenSorrentino.com, and go click on some of the video, and you'll get a few really quite good laughs, because he does everyone from Jerry Lewis to Elton John, which he's most famous for. A lot of musical impressions, Billy Joel, Bruce Springsteen, all those people, and he does it in a funny way. Anyway, we'll be talking to him soon. Let me tell you a little bit more about this program. First of all, it would not exist at this point were it not for our beloved and wonderful and blessed sponsors. So let's welcome them. I always say that we're going to get them out of the way, but that's not right, because they're crucial to the show and to the spirit of the show and to the family feeling that we try and have on Dave's Gone By. So thank you in a big but quick way to Hewlett Minuteman Press, the Copy Kings of Broadway, located at 1315 Broadway in Hewlett, and their number is 516-569-5577. 10% discount on any job, big or small, if you tell them Dave sent you at Hewlett Minuteman Press in Hewlett. That number again, 516-569-5577, and they're open 6 days a week. Also, this program is brought to you by the Woodrow Delicatessen. They've been in business for 40-something years. I and my family, sorry about the grammar there, have been going to the Woodrow for, pardon me, since I was in my early teens. Since we moved to Long Island, that has become our deli. And we don't just go there because it's pretty convenient to where we live. We go there because the food is so fresh and so good. Everything from pastrami, corned beef, roast chicken, all different kinds of chicken. The roast chicken is delicious, and they do a fried chicken, but they also have Polynesian chicken, and Hawaiian chicken salad, and barbecue chicken, and of course all those specialty things like stuffed cabbage, and you can get yourself a delicious Frankfurter too. It's all at the Woodrow Deli, 1342 Peninsula Boulevard. They're in the Peninsula Shopping Center, in fact, and you can find out more at woodrowdeli.com. Now please notice that I'm saying it in a very strange way. I'm not saying Woodrow Deli. I'm saying Woodrow Deli. Because you got to leave off that second W. It's just W-O-O-D-R-O, deli.com. They leave off the last W for wonderful. We've been tweaking that tagline for the past couple of weeks. I'm not sure that's the one that will stick. But so far, it's a little better than leave off the W for pastrami. So it goes. Anyway, we also want to thank our sponsor, Performing Arts Insider Theater Magazine, the Bible of Broadway since 1944. Go to performingartsinsider.com to find out more about this incredible journal, which looks like in January it's going to get another makeover and have some of the pages in color and have some new and even easier to read layouts. So definitely check it out. If you just want to get one issue or if you want to subscribe for a whole season, go to performingartsinsider.com. And remember, Dave Is Gone By listeners get a really major discount on subscriptions there. You gotta go to davesgoneby.org to find out just how much. And our final sponsor, Fancy Schmancy Balloons for all your party decorating needs. It's not just balloons, it's centerpieces. It's really making your party look the best it possibly can. Jeff Goodman, who is normally my guest co-host on the program, but he's busy calling bingo at the local synagogue tonight, and he'll probably be rushing over before the end of the show to say hi. So, first of all, big shout-out to Jeff Goodman, and I'll give him an 069! Woohoo! And hope that he's having a good time over at the synagogue. Hope to see him soon, but by all means, give Jeff a call if you're having a Thanksgiving party. Certainly, now that the holidays are going to be rolling around, call him at 516-797-3229, 797-3229 for all your party decorating needs. Fancy schmancy balloons. And finally, just want to remind you a couple of things about the show and this program. You can find out so much information at davesgoneby.org. Remember to spell it like my name, Dave. davesgoneby.org. And the really cool thing is we're loading up more and more of our older episodes as podcasts, absolutely free, complete uncut episodes. And we have now more than 60 episodes. Literally every single Dave's Gone By that we have done from August 2007 up through now is online free for you to listen to anytime. Because I hear people say, oh, you know, you're on at 11, or you're okay, the station's okay in my car to a certain point, but then I run out of range, or it's too staticky, or I gotta go to sleep on, you know, get up early Monday morning. No more excuses. You can't listen every Sunday night at 11. Go to davesgoneby.org, click on the archives, and listen to all these shows anytime. Well, we're going to be listening to the voices and the humor of Stephen Sorrentino in just a moment or two, but turns out, because my voice is going a little bit, I'm not going to be doing that particular interview. Hopefully it will be an interview because I want to make sure I can get him on the phone. But assuming that he's there live with us on the phone, I want to give my voice a rest and get somebody back on here who hasn't really been on the show in a few weeks. And that is the one and only Rabbi Saul Solomon, the spiritual leader of Temple Sons of Bitches in Great Neck, New York. Rabbi Saul is a somewhat polarizing figure, but he's become rather beloved in the neighborhood. And he also has that TV show that you can see on cablevision, Shalom Dammit. And you see that Wednesday mornings and Friday mornings. I'll give that information later if there's time. But anyway, you'll get to hear him now talking to Stephen Sorrentino. But first, well, like everything else, we got to do a little more business, and then we'll be back in the neighborhood. Print it, copy it, send it as a gift. All that and more at Hewlett Minuteman Press, your full-service printer. Family-owned and operated since 1975. Photocopying, printing, wedding invitations, and grave gifts. Minuteman, 1315 Broadway in Hewlett. Call 516-569-5577, 569-5577, on the web at hewlett.minutemanpress.com, and mention Dave's Gone By to get 10% off. Here are 15 reasons why you should visit the Woodrow Delicatessen in Hewlett. Brisket, hot open roast beef, barbecue chicken, chicken fricassee, Polynesian chicken, frankfurters, stuffed cabbage, Romanian tenderloin, fresh turkey off the bone, matzo ball soup, French fries, corned beef, pastrami, seven-layer cake, and Hawaiian chicken salad. And here are three more reasons. The Woodrow is kosher, open daily in the Peninsula Shopping Center, and they cater. Woodrow Deli. How many reasons do you need? Marriage, babies, and the end of the world. It's a book. It's funny. I know, because I wrote it. And you should buy it. At my website, davesgoneby.org. Are you reading me? Are you reading me? Are you hearing me? This is Dave of Dave's Gone By. We just had a little bit of technical glitches, but we're actually here. We're okay. I want to get the rabbi in the room because the rabbi is in the house, and the rabbi will be talking to Stephen Sorrentino in just a moment. Rabbi, he has to do his usual pre-interview prep. Hold on.
Damn it. Play. Shalom, everybody. Oh, I'm so happy to be back on the radio with you and with Dave and with all of us in this pre-holiday time. This is as we near the American holiday of Thanksgiving and the Goyisha holiday of you-know-what-mas, and of course, Hanukkah. Little early for that, little early to be thinking about these things, but it is never too early to enjoy yourself, to have fun, to enjoy humor, and to laugh, and be sameach. And this is why I am so happy to have the honor to be talking to an entertainer, a comedian, someone who does music, somebody who dances around. His name is Stephen Sorrentino. Certainly not a Jewish name, but that's all right. I talk to all types. And he is here with us on the telephone right now. Stephen Sorrentino, how are you? Bruchim Abayim, welcome to the neighborhood.
Hello, Rabbi. How are you?
I'm, don't ask. The ailments you shouldn't know from it. How are you, I should ask?
I'm doing good. It's about a little early here in Las Vegas, so how are you over at the late night in New York?
Oh, it's so cold here. Oh, my God, I'm freezing my my matzo balls off, if I may use that thing there. Are you surrounded by fire over there, or is that just California?
No, just California. We get a little bit of smoke, though, but that's probably my next-door neighbor. It's okay.
Well, well, then there's smoke, there's marijuana. This is right. What I was taught when I was by the Rebbes. So, let me ask you something. You're in Vegas right now, but you're going to be in New York very soon, am I correct?
Yes, I'm going to Germany first. I'm going to Frankfurt, Berlin.
Wait a minute, you're going to Germany?
Yeah.
What the hell is wrong? Why are you going to Germany?
It's cool over there now. Don't worry about it.
But not so cool. They got the Neos and the shaven heads and the cloven hooves. Oh, no. What's so important that you have to go to Germany?
A gig. Money.
Well, all right. This I understand to an extent.
I got to do shows.
There's no money in Israel? There's
no money? Of course there is. They just don't like me there. I don't know what happened.
Oh, really?
Something I said.
Is this true? Did you really?
No, I'm kidding.
I'm just checking. You haven't angered me yet,
and I'm a good boy.
I'm very easy to anger. I angry up my blood very quickly. You'll find.
Well, please don't do that with me. I'm a nice boy.
You sound like a charmer. You sound very sweet, and you're very funny. Dave and I have watched your videos, and we've laughed, and we've tumbled, and we touched in certain ways that I can't describe on the air. It was good.
Ay.
Very nice. So, how is Vegas? Different.
Beautiful. It's beautiful here. I love Vegas, but it's the first time this is starting to get a little cold, nip in the air, and it's kind of nice. And it's we're just got back from a little boat ride here on Lake Sahara. Believe it or not.
Lake. Is that a joke too? Is there an actual Lake Sahara?
I'm not kidding. There's a place called Lake Sahara. You know, don't say it.
So there's people starving all over the world with no water, but they built a lake in Las Vegas. This is America for you.
Everybody's nuts.
No, but I was going to ask is how is playing in Las Vegas where you do a show different from the shows you do elsewhere in America and all over the world?
You know, what I do is I just do what I do and hope other people like it. So I kind of do my brand of humor, my impressions, the musical that I sing. I sing all kinds of songs, everything from Led Zeppelin to Ethel Merman.
The Merm.
What I do.
Oh, please do some Merm. You have to do me some Merm, please.
Everything's coming up roses.
I'm ready to go.
Give out. The testicles I have are now just shooting up through my neck.
I know, me too. My gavilta just fell off.
I have a very serious Las Vegas question for you.
Go ahead. Yeah,
I need, in sort of a spiritual sense, to know this.
Okay, this is between you and I only.
Just between you and me and the four people listening in the radio now. And you're laughing at that.
Yes, that's funny. Yeah.
Now, what radio station? We should be so lucky. Okay. Serious. Okay. In Vegas, the showgirls.
Yes.
Are the boobs real?
No.
I knew it!
It's theirs because they purchased them, but they're their boobs. They're not original.
Oh, my.
Everything is second issue here.
So wait, they got used boobs?
No, yes.
Is there a store where I can go and try on the merchandise at some point?
Yes, they have pre-owned rabbi boobs. I don't know if you know that new
place. No, I didn't.
Yes, right on Sahara. That's beautiful.
I got to go.
There's more silicone here than it used to be in California, believe me.
Remind me to Google that. I've got the rabbi boob store. I'll have to look for that next time I'm there. This is
absolutely
the reason to come to Vegas, let me tell you.
That's right. Every moil shouldn't be without one or two.
Now, let me ask you a bit more about your persona and the way you do the comedy that you do.
Why do that now? Why start now?
Why get serious? Why bother?
I can't get serious. Go ahead.
Well, I wonder about this. Are there families of impressions that sound enough like each other so that if you do one, you basically can do another? Like if you can do Jay Leno, that means you can do Bugs Bunny. If you can do Jimmy Stewart, you can do Kate Hepburn because the voice goes like this.
Exactly.
Is that true?
Yes, it is true. I mean, I truly believe that there's only four impressions or four types of voices, and from there you dial in the different things. Like Jose Feliciano is the same as James Taylor, who is the same as the Bee Gees.
Jose Feliciano is the same as James Taylor? I would not let one of them drive.
James Taylor's all right, but he had a little problem with the stuff. You know, once he's off the sauce, he's fine. But it's the same type of voice. Now, Chico, don't be discouraged. It's almost, it's the same as when you're down in trouble and you need a helping hand. It's the same guy. One guy could see and the other guy drinks too much.
Hey, at least he's off the heroin. This is it's a step
forward. Good thing.
So what's another grouping of people who a little change and they're totally different people, but they're still in the same category?
There's a whole bunch of those are my favorite ones out there. But the Jay Leno thing, Jay Leno's kind of funny because it's just a bit of
that's good.
All, folks. Same guy.
Right.
Same guy. You know, I'm trying to think of some other stuff like with Tom Jones. Hello there, Tom Jones. You know, and I think it's not only you who wants to be loved by anyone. If you do an Engelbert Humperdinck, it's the same voice.
Tom Jones and
Humperdinck. Yeah, and Jerry Lewis again. Hello, hey, Selene, hi. You know, anything that you're gonna.
Did you just say filet a hymen?
Well, I could, but that would be on the menu.
Well, we have a kind of a fishy taste, if you know what I'm saying. But you know.
Hey, Rabbi.
So are there any impressions that you're dying to do, but they're not in your range, or they're too difficult, or you're okay, but you're still working on them?
No, Rabbi, I tell you what. I've worked really hard for a very long time to do what I can do, and my range is as good as it's going to get. Sometimes the high notes, the dogs kind of leave the room. And the low stuff I could do. So I thankfully, I'm a Long Island boy, originally born and raised in Long Island, East Islip, New York.
Oh, you're kidding.
Yeah, and I'm originally from Long Island. That's why it's so cool that I'm playing Belly Laughs in Farmingdale.
Oh, this is what I wanted to mention. When are you playing Belly Laughs in Farmingdale?
Well, it's funny that you mentioned that because I was wondering when you were going to plug that gig. But it is coming up, kid. It's coming up in a couple of weeks, right after Thanksgiving. It is Belly Laughs in Farmingdale, New York. And it is on November 28th and 29th at 9 p.m.
Why so late?
I don't know.
You couldn't get a 7 o'clock where people have to sleep? I'm stuck at 11. That's my misery. But you?
Well, listen, 9 p.m. is 7 o'clock, 6 o'clock at my time in Vegas, so I'll be wide awake. Then again, what time is it in Germany?
Oh, I am not. It's time for the Jews to come out of the graves in Germany. That's what time it is, goddammit.
God. You're bringing the whole movement back 40 years. You're killing me.
60 years, but who's counting?
No, but years, exactly.
28th and the 29th, those are a weekend, people.
Yes,
so it's not like you have to get up for work. It's fine.
No, it's the day after Thanksgiving and the day after that. Friday and Saturday, 9 o'clock p.m., Belly Laughs in performing down there. I don't normally play clubs. I don't play comedy clubs. I don't think I've ever played a comedy club, to tell you the truth. I do showrooms, which is usually a lot of more people. But I'm looking forward because it's up close and personal. I'm going to be sitting on... I'm doing lap dances, Rabbi.
Oh, yeah.
I'm doing right in the front.
Not on my lap, you're not.
Oh, well, not if you sit in the front, you have to deal with the deal.
Well, why do you why are you choosing to do a comedy club? Are you trying to stretch, as it were?
No. A friend of mine bought the place, and I said I would do it. As that, and you know what? I get emails all the time. I get snail mail emails, phone calls. People say, when are you coming back to Long Island? You lived here, you grew up here, you learned your craft, and you took it elsewhere. So I kind of feel bad, and I got guilted. You know about guilt, right?
Oh, more than you should ever know!
And there you have it. So I got guilted into coming back to Long Island, and they said, you want to play belly laughs? I said, yes. I say yes to everything. So I was happy to come back. And there I am. I'm coming back to Long Island, Long New York.
For two nights. But where is your home base? Do you live in Vegas?
I have a home here in Las Vegas. I have a home in Key Largo.
Good Lord, you're doing all right.
And also a place in the Hamptons that I don't go to that often. Once in a while, I go back for a couple of days. But that's it.
So have you thought of making donations to a particular synagogue at this point?
You can speak to my representation. We'll let you know. Anyway, but I do have all of my stuff is here in Las Vegas. So I'm here about 90% of the time. I'm a Las Vegas boy, man. I'm Elvis. I'm a woo. Thank you very much.
What? Could you describe your Vegas show? I mean, it's going to be a smaller thing when you're in Farmingdale, but
yeah,
people can't necessarily fly to Vegas to see it. I know we can all see some clips of it on YouTube, but tell us about the Vegas program. And let me also ask the person who is calling in to talk, could you please call back later? But I'm not on the air, damn it! Idiot.
Well, maybe the person's calling in to talk to me.
I wonder. Shall we find this out? I'll probably knock you off the air looking and trying to figure it out. All right, they're gone. Goodbye.
That's good. Goodbye. That's that. Well, as long as I don't owe the money. If it's somebody that says I owe money, it's not me. My Vegas show is a little bit bigger. I've got a 10-piece orchestra and 10 beautiful dancers. 10 dancers.
10 beautiful dancers with 20 fake boobs.
That's right. It's fabulous. That's like almost like, yeah, that's great. And it's a little bit more musical because I have a bigger band, but I'm doing music. I'm going to be doing comedy. I'm going to be doing impressions. I'm going to try to do about 180 different impressions during the belly laugh gig.
I don't even know 180 people. In my life, I've never met 180. You're doing 180 impressions.
You got to get out more.
So here's the obvious. There's the obvious question for you. Come on, be my trained puppy and give me some impressions, and let me see if I can guess who... Oh, I hope that's not a bra if I guess wrong, but then again, I know nothing about culture. Can you give me a few impressions, and maybe I can see if I can... I know who these people are?
Okay, we'll do a speed round, if I can focus this good.
Well, do some speed, and then do the round here.
I haven't done that since Studio 54, 1977. Oh! Hold on a second. Okay, ready? Can we talk?
That would be Joan Rivers.
Very good. Hey, Mo!
This would be the Curly Stooge.
Curly.
I don't know what the hell. Curly Howard. Something.
If you can ask your listeners what Curly's real name was, we'll give him a free ticket to the show.
Oh, that's Curly, so nice.
Curly, his on the show, what was his real name? The guy, and if you could tell me their real Jewish name, their Yiddish name, I'll give you two tickets. Not one.
Do you actually know the answer to that one?
Yes, I do. Of course.
Okay.
I'm a film historian. I love that stuff. Like, my house is a museum here. I have Red Skelton stuff in my living room. Please, don't even...
Wait, this is actually interesting to me. And it's very rare that something's interesting to me, so let's follow this. So you have actual... Oh, someone, let us, first of all, let us take this phone caller who seems to be so intent upon calling us. Maybe they'll know the answer to the question.
Go ahead.
All right, Dave's gone. Bye. Rabbi Saul, you're on the air. Who's calling, please?
Rabbi Saul, you gotta open up your front door right now.
Oh, my God, they must have locked it behind me. We're going to have my special guest co-host coming on the air. So tell you what, I'm going to do
Rabbi,
yeah.
Be careful, because there could be a flaming bag of dog poop. You never know, they do that. And then you step on it, and then the whole night is ruined.
Actually, that's just my wife's cooking. My dear wife, Miriam Libby. She tells me she's making a cake. She tells me she's making a surprise. You might as well be a flaming bag of dog poop.
Well, I can tell it from here. Go ahead.
Why don't you tell the audience a little bit more about your show?
Okay.
Especially the one you're going to do in Farmingdale.
Yes, okay, here we go.
And I'll be right back.
Go ahead, I got it. Hi, everybody, this is Steven Tarantino from Las Vegas, Nevada. I'm coming to beautiful Belly Laughs Comedy Club on the day after Thanksgiving, Friday and Saturday, rather, the 28th and 29th of November. It starts at 9 o'clock. Come on down. I think it's $20 a seat. Come on down and see me doing every impression I could possibly think of. Jerry Lewis doing Led Zeppelin. It's going to be a wacky night. I have video stuff. I have props. I'm going to be doing stand-up. I'm going to be doing music. It's the most diverse comedy show that's ever been in a comedy club, bar none. Rabbi, are you back? I guess not. You know, folks, Rabbi has a big door very far away, and unfortunately he has to walk on his knees. Don't ask me why. It's a long story, but these are the things. Never before have I had to buy this much time on a radio.
I hope you didn't say any four-legged words or anything awful.
Of course
awful.
Not, Rabbi. I'm a good Catholic boy that actually used to sing in Yiddish for Yiddish and Bar Mitzvah.
Well. Yiddish? What the hell is Yiddish? That's what Jewish people speak. By the way, let me...
Yes, the short Jewish people.
I know where that comes from. First of all, I want to welcome... How can we have another phone call? We never have phone calls on this program.
Well, that's unpopular, people.
Let's take another call.
Open your door.
Dave's gone by. Rabbi Saul, you're on the air. What would you like to say?
Hey, how's it going? I want to talk to Steve, and I have the answer to his question.
This
okay,
is wonderful.
Go ahead.
Where are you from, and what's your name, please?
I am from Ronkonkoma, Long Island. My name is Johnny.
Hello, Johnny. Thank you for listening to Dave's Gone By. And how did you hear about the show, first of all?
Well, I got a email saying that Steven was going to be on your show, and I follow Steven all over, and I'm so glad he's coming to Long Island.
It's a fan, Rabbi. It's
You're a fan, I tell you.
Fan,
this is fantastic. My guest co-host for Dave's Gone By, Jeff, has come in, and he says it's not really fan, it's more like a stalker.
We call those stalkers.
Okay, well, let's hear the kid's answer. Okay,
Johnny, what's the answer?
The answer is Jerome Horowitz.
Well, say it again. Jerome what?
Horowitz.
Well, I'm going to give it to you anyway. It's actually Jerome Hovitz. Was the Howard brothers were actually Hovitz, H-O-V-I-T-Z. They were the Hovitz brothers, and Jerome was Curly. So we're going to give you two tickets to the show.
Thank you, Steven.
My pleasure. Hey, do me
Good
a favor,
job.
Rabbi. Write his number down, and we'll have my secretary tomorrow morning call him back and get him two free tickets.
Well, can you do me a favor?
Yes. We'll just hold on the phone, and then when
yeah,
we...
Yeah, you'll have to hold it until commercial or perhaps until...
Well, why don't you take yourself off, Mike, and I'll talk
well,
to
why don't you just give me his name, or could you give me his name on the air, or did he get stalked or what? Was this
well, no, but he has to get the tickets and all that.
No,
so...
just give me his name. I'll leave him at the door. What's your name, kid?
My name is Johnny.
Johnny what?
Johnny Rotten?
Sorry, what was that?
Capasso, C-A-P-A-S-S-O.
And your social security number is?
I was just going to ask for that.
Okay, Johnny, you got which night do you want? You want Friday or Saturday?
Saturday.
You've got a Saturday night, 9 o'clock show. There'll be two tickets waiting for you, and Mo Howard's daughter will be there looking for you.
Oh.
Really?
She's really good looking.
Thank you.
But always remember to put the hand up on between your eyes on your nose so you don't get the two fingers in the eye.
Why you?
Thank you, Rabbi.
Thank you. Thank
okay,
you so much for calling in.
Have a great night.
You too, Johnny. Keep
bye
listening.
Bye. Thank
Who
you.
Knew I have a fan?
This is a
thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Johnny.
All right, shut up. Go away.
Okay. Yeah, you want
to
get
what are you going to be rude to my fans for? I got three fans, Rabbi.
He just got a ticket. Two tickets. That was very nice of you, by the way. That was
I just lost $40. I'm dying over here.
No, you're killing. You're not dying. You're killing.
But you gained a stalker, so don't worry.
So do you have any questions, Jeff, for Steven Sorrentino, the impressionist, the Vegas entertainer? Because you're in Vegas.
Where do you play in Vegas? Where do you play in Vegas? I love Vegas.
What do you care about Vegas? I'm trying to get people to come to New York. You're asking me about Vegas.
Oh, I like Vegas,
about
though.
Vegas. Never mind Vegas.
So where are you playing here?
Oh, you said this already.
You must have just came in.
He did.
I was locked outside. What can I do?
Okay. So listeners, I tell you what. Why don't I send you a press release and... Those of you listeners, go get a piece of bread now while I tell this guy where we just
or matzah. Matzah works just fine.
Matzah's nice. Get yourself some nice soup or whatever you want. I'm going to be at Belly Laughs in Farmingdale, New York, which is Belly Laughs, 261 Airport Plaza Boulevard, Farmingdale, New York, 1175.
I know where that is.
You do?
It's and right by my house.
Yeah.
It used to be a different name club.
Yeah.
What was it called? Was that?
It used to be a nightmare. No, it used to be Dave and Buster's.
Oh. So they didn't take over a comedy club. They took over like a
Dave and Buster's.
An eating kind of a place.
No, it was Dave and Buster's had games and all
well,
that, too. Yeah.
So
it's an entertainment complex.
Right. It's called Belly Laughs Club at Dave and Buster's. So I guess it's, yes, one part of the same place.
Excellent. Yeah. It's a beautiful place over there.
Is it? I should be proud to be
You're
there.
You're in a high rent district, by the way. Only
I'm
little airplanes going over your head, by the way.
Now, let me ask you a question. We're talking with Steven Sorrentino, the entertainer, the musical comedian. Let me ask, how do you deal, since you've been doing this for almost two decades, am I correct?
Yes, exactly.
How do you deal with hecklers?
I try to shoot them in the eye.
There you go.
That always seems to work for me.
We have another
phone
call.
You are so popular, we have another phone call.
You don't have more tickets to give away. This is just a phone call, right?
All right, let's talk to somebody in over here, and we'll find out if they're a heckler so I can shoot them in the eye. Go ahead.
All right. You're listening to Dave's Gone By. This is Rabbi Saul Solomon, and you are on the air. How may we help you? Hello?
Yes, I'm a fan of Stephen Sorrentino's.
This is wonderful.
Get another fan. This is two of the three fans in my life right here.
So how long
are you going to be in Farmingdale? Are you coming to Farmingdale?
I'm coming all the way from Myrtle Beach, South Carolina.
Wow.
Get involved. She is a stalker.
Are you driving or walking?
I'm driving 14 hours.
Wow. Dave, you can't go to Myrtle Beach. It's so much nicer in the winter.
Well, I wish.
That's not. No place like Long Island.
That's what I'm talking about.
But how did you find out about Stephen Sorrentino?
Oh, I know him for many years.
Okay.
So what do you like? What's your favorite thing about him?
Great performer.
I'm sorry, what was that?
Great guy, great performer.
What's your favorite thing that he does?
His Elton John skit.
Oh, the Elton John. He's really famous for the Elton John.
Yeah, I don't know if your listeners know this, but for 10 years, I was the number one Elton John impersonator worldwide. I actually toured 20-some-odd countries as Elton John, like in a tribute show.
And you actually went to California to get married, I heard.
Who, Elton?
No, you.
No, not really. They kind of like ended that anyway, but we're trying to get it in Las Vegas so I can get the rabbi and his friend down here.
Oh, that's very nice.
Wouldn't it be nice?
Cola, do you have a question?
No, I just want to say how good of a performer he is.
And what's your name? Where are you calling from? Darling. Well, North Carolina. South Carolina or something.
That's right.
Myrtle Beach.
My name is Jolene, and I'm calling from Myrtle Beach, South Carolina.
Jolene, I'm going to see you. Which night are you coming down to the show?
I'm coming Saturday.
All right, I'm going to shout out to South Carolina, Myrtle Beach, when you're there.
Very nice.
Sure.
Jolene.
Sure.
See, everybody's joining the neighborhood tonight. Jolene, I'm going to thank you so much for calling in. I'm sure you will have a wonderful time
and
at Belly Laughs.
If you find the rabbi in the audience, maybe he'll buy you a drink.
A very watered-down cheap drink because I got no money, but, you know, it'll be a kosher drink. This I promise.
Well, thanks for calling in, Jolene. We'll see you then.
No problem. Take care.
Bless
you. Have a safe trip,
thanks
Jolene.
A lot.
Thank you so much.
I'm famous already.
Isn't that great?
This is amazing. We should get along every week. We actually get an audience. Has Elton John ever seen you perform?
He has seen the videos of me. I actually worked for Elton John when I was 18 years old in New York at Rocket Records.
Wait a minute. What did you do? What was he like?
I was personal assistant to his manager at the time, but I was a kid. I was still in high school.
He was a rocket man.
He was more than a rocket man. He was actually a really cool guy. At the time, it was the crazy 70s, so I learned how to do a lot of things like kind of looking to try to produce shows, how to do lighting and stuff like that, but I also learned how to do good and bad things, but it was a great experience, and he was one of the nicest people in the world, honestly. Very, believe it or not, humble.
Wow.
With his $350 million at the time. So
at the time, you already had it.
By the way, did he teach you how to use a bedazzler?
No, the bedazzler I got on my own. I think Sally Jesse Raphael taught me that one.
But I've heard this rumor, and it's not a bad thing, but it's not a... I hear that he might possibly be a fagler. Is this true?
You and Jackie Mason use that terminology. And my buddy Marty Allen. Remember Marty Allen?
How is he doing? Get him
Marty
on this program.
Marty is one of my best friends. He lives a couple of doors away. Marty and I just wrote a bunch of material for him. He's out on cruise ships.
Wow.
He's 86 years old and he's still out there.
How old?
86.
God bless him.
And still with the hair.
He's still got the Brillo hair.
I love it. Wonderful. Love it.
Please talk to him. I would love to have Marty Allen on this program.
Yeah, I can get Marty for you. When he's in town, he's working a lot, though.
Well, of course. He's the only one from his generation still alive.
Well, him and Pat Cooper and another neighbor of mine is Jerry Lewis, who is still out there, and he's actually going to be performing again soon here in Las Vegas.
Do you know Jerry Lewis?
I do know Jerry Lewis.
Jerry Lewis is my favorite collection. My lady.
Love him.
By the way, you live in Vegas?
You don't like the Lewis.
Probably the kind.
Okay. Well, I just want to, because honestly,
I know you're coming into the show halfway here. Yes, I live in Las Vegas most of the time. I would say 90%.
Okay. But no, because I actually visit Vegas about 90% of my time.
Really?
Yeah. I love Vegas.
Good. Let's keep talking about Vegas so we can sell tickets to the place in Long Island.
Well, don't worry. I'll stand out on Route 110 with a sign going, this is Airport Plaza.
You'll see the sign.
By the way, if they want to know exactly where the Dave and Buster's is, all you have to do is go up 110. It's on the the east side of the street, there's a very big multiplex and a Staples. You're right near the Staples and Home Depot.
Oh, yeah. Find the Staples in Long Island. That's a good... Oh, boy.
No, the Staples and Home Depot on 110.
That's a hell of a landmark.
Shut up, Rabbi.
Oh, there's a Dunkin' Donuts, too.
No, no Dunkin' Donuts.
There's a gas station.
No, there's a Chinese... there's a Chinese... the
yeah, wait, yellow lines painted down the middle of the street. This is a good thing.
This is a nightmare. Wait, you mean there's a Chinese restaurant in Long Island?
Yeah, imagine that. And you know, sometimes the Jews are there on Sundays.
And Christmas Eve. Yeah. I said the C word, Rabbi. I said the C word.
What?
Christmas.
Christmas Eve.
Oh, oi. Point, point, toy, toy.
Well, we have to go somewhere Christmas Day also, you know.
Well, then you guys always go to the Chinese restaurant. That's all the Jewish friends.
Sometimes we do Thai, just to mix things up a little bit.
Oh, don't get me started on Thailand.
Oh, please. Now, a couple of more questions, because we do have to move along, but not before I ask Stephen Sorrentino, how do you, as a performer and a business person, budget your time? How much is spent writing new material, performing, then marketing, self-promotion, and then doing all the financial stuff? How do you balance?
I think the best thing to do is, first off, you have to just get the gigs, get the work, and everything else fills and fits into place. You have a job. While you're on the job, you're repping during the day. You're working on your finances. You're working on your promo. You're selling tickets. You're doing radio shows. But as long as you have the job, God bless, that's the pinnacle of the importance.
It's always important to work.
Exactly. And I also develop real estate. I have a couple other companies. So I'm a busy guy. I produce 9 different shows.
You're doing real estate. Now, why did you have to play in Long Island?
I want to know about his 9 shows that he produces.
Yeah, I produce those. You go to evenstevenproductions.com, even Steven with a PH, Steven, that's my name. And you can see the other shows I produce. I just had a show in San Diego. I got one tonight, actually, playing in at the Soaring Eagle Hotel Casino in Michigan.
The Sarajevo Hotel?
The Soaring Eagle.
Not Sarajevo. Oh. Soaring Eagle.
I was wondering about that. There are landmines in the lobby.
The rabbi hasn't met a Q-tip he likes to use yet.
What?
My God. Rabbi's smoking something back there, I'll tell you.
One
you bring something in. I love it.
One more question for Stephen. And first of all, you've been a great sport. You've been delightful. I would love to hear you do a few
more. Most people hang up on the rabbi, by the way.
Oh, is that right? The rabbi.
Can you do Mandy Patinkin? Can you do a Mandy Patinkin impersonation?
No, not even Mandy could do Mandy these days.
I can. He hung up on the rabbi.
No. I'm trying to think of what he did in Evita, in the original version.
He walked around, he overacted, that's what he didn't have.
He did overact, but I think he's a fabulous actor, I love him.
I know.
You can look at my website, stevensorrentino.com, I've been in a bunch of movies, sitcoms, I've done a lot of
What's
stuff.
What's the last movie you were in, Steven?
What's that?
What's the last movie you were in?
The last movie I was in, unfortunately, was in Hungary, which, from the paycheck, I was remained hungry. It was called Getno. But you can see it online. If you go onto my website, you can see all the films I've
done. Is it a satisfying movie? And you get no satisfaction?
I get nothing.
That's terrible. That's
you get no pay.
So let me ask you one more question, Stephen Sorrentino.
The third one more question.
One more. Well, I keep this idiot here. It's interrupting me, damn it.
I love
you. If you weren't
guys.
Jewish, I wouldn't. No, I'm just kidding. I love you. I love you. You're a beautiful man.
I'm going to commit rabbi side soon.
What the hell? Rabbi side. He has a can of Zyklon B that he's holding up against the window.
Rabbi, are you coming to the show?
I would be honored. I would love to see this.
What is the date again?
I want you to stand up to. My name is Danny Gann.
Oh, I have Danny Gann stories for you.
I bet you do. Don't we all?
Yeah.
No, wait, you tell your Danny Gann story. What story?
No, I don't have any Danny Gann. I'm one of his contemporaries. We are best of friends, and he's a wonderful man.
And what about Fred Travellina? Do you wish him dead?
Well, no, Fred
Travellina.
Because he's your main competition, not for anything bad he does.
No, Fred's not my competition. Bless
Who's your competition, then?
Oh, I don't know, but Fred's
We don't name them. We kill them.
Fred does a different type of show than I. He's a wonderful man. He had cancer. Be nice to him.
He's an impressionist, Travellina, right?
So
he does impressions. Fred does great impressions. He's a wonderful man.
How about doing your homework before you walk into the studio sometimes?
Don't lock me out of the studio. That's all I could tell you.
Who else do you want to bash that had cancer?
God.
Let's talk bad about people.
John McCain.
Eye infection or something.
Well, let's talk about Betty Ford.
Oh, well, absolutely.
We can shoe polish that one off. All right.
Oh,
how would some of your characters,
yes,
Stephen Sorrentino, react to the election of Barack Obama?
I think they'd all be really happy about
it. Well, can you do, not to put you on the spot, but I'm putting you on the spot.
Okay. How about Gilbert Gottfried?
Oh, please.
This is wonderful. I'm having a wonderful time with it. It's nice because, you know, Obama's nice. Oh, it's Affleck.
And of course, I think he'll also get a couple more commercials with Obama in office.
Bravo. One or two more. Give us a couple more.
That's it. That's all you get. Listen, come to the show. See the thing.
If you want a person, you got to pay for it. You got to go to the Airport Plaza to the Dave and Buster's.
I got to tell you another piece of information right now.
What's that?
This is something that no one knows. You know the stork on the Vlasic pickle?
Yes, you know, Vlasic.
I have a Vlasic pickle. That's me. I'm the guy from the Vlasic pickle.
I really? Love you! Oh!
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
I
every
love
time
pickle.
You buy a pickle, I get a half a penny. Buy more pickles.
You got a little crunch there.
That's right.
That's a wonderful. Can you do a little more of the Groucho? That's a beautiful Groucho.
Hi, Groucho Marx is one of my favorite characters. I'm a good friend with his nephew, who is Harpo's son, Bill. Bill Marx is a fantastic piano player in Palm Springs, and he's fantastic.
Can you do what Gilbert does and do, like, old, really old and desiccated Groucho?
No, because
he's not Gilbert.
Desiccated? You mean defecated?
That too. No, that's me sometimes.
Well, Gilbert says it. I think you're talking about when Groucho was very old. He was. Groucho was wonderful. Let's not talk about
it. All right, we're not going to speak ill of the characters. Not speak ill of the dead. Who can I talk about?
Well, we love Groucho more.
Who's the other guy, Jeff?
Yeah, that's me.
Jeff, would you do me a favor? Go on to Google. Find out who's dying of cancer. We can do impressions of them.
Okay.
Well, who's that actor? The one in Dirty Dancing.
Oh, yeah, Patrick Swayze.
Yeah, he has a couple of days left. Go ahead,
dance
him.
There you go.
That's
very good. Well, if they cut half his leg off, it's like, I had the time of my life.
Nobody messes with baby.
This is evil. I'm sorry. I wish I were Catholic so I could confess, but unfortunately...
I'm going to have to go to Mass tomorrow. Nightmare. What's a mess?
What's
the M word?
It's a mess.
That's
it's
right.
It's a mess. Hey, gentlemen, thank you so much.
Thank you.
I appreciate it. I didn't even know I had two fans that listened to your show. I'm so happy.
Me too.
I love you guys, and I love my fans out there, and everybody come see me. It'll be so nice to be back.
Remind everyone, it's this November 28th and 29th, Friday and
right.
Saturday night at Belly.
Oh, my God.
What?
I'm going to be in Vegas.
Dead, yeah.
Can he dial in and listen by phone?
How ironic is that?
That is ironic. You got to stay at my house?
Sure.
That's nice.
Very good. Don't let me the fish.
If your house is called the Imperial Palace.
Oh, you're staying at the Imperial? Boy, you're really springing for some dough. What is that, $1.99 a week?
I go wherever they give me free rooms, please. I'm also staying in Sam's Town.
Oh, my God.
That's a series of cardboard boxes in the road.
Sam's Town, I can park my RV.
Sam's Town is Shantytown.
Well,
holy mackerel.
Thank you for being with us in the Shantytown. We call it Daverhood on Dave's Gone By. Everybody go see Stephen Sorrentino and remind us, what is your website for all your information?
www.stephensorrentino.com.
And that's Sorrentino with two R's.
And it's Stephen with a
PH. With a PH.
Well,
we're going to raise our PH level now with some commercials, but thank you again. Bless you, and good luck with your show on the 28th and the 29th. And Jeff wants to say one last thing.
No, I just want to say goodbye.
Okay, and I got goodbye, Mazel Tov.
And we have to talk because I have so much to tell you.
Yeah,
and
you
I will be at the airport plaza.
You'll be at the regular airport going to Vegas.
The comedy, no, I will be there in spirit. This is the
Belly Laughs.
Now
right?
This is Belly Laughs Comedy Club in Dave and Buster's at Airport Plaza in Farmingdale. That's on Route 110 on the
right.
28th and 29th. At what time?
It's at 9 o'clock. And if you want tickets, the reservations at 631-742-4605. That's 631-742-4605.
Because then you're not giving them away. They're going fast.
That's right.
Well,
thank you, Stephen.
On both dates, guys. We'll see you soon.
Shalom to you.
Shalom.
Old episodes of Dave's Gone By don't die. They just get archived on CD and on the internet. They're on CD for just $10, including shipping and handling. Makes a wonderful gift. But if you just want to listen on your computer, you can go to davesgoneby.org and see all the archives and listen to them free anytime at all, including a list of what's been on every episode of Dave's Gone By. So go to davesgoneby.org for all the information you need to know to hear me on CD. Inside Broadway, brought to you by Performing Arts Insider Theater Magazine and TogleTheater.com.
Performing Arts Insider Theater Magazine, the Bible of Broadway, for so many years. Boy, what a lively show. I want to thank the rabbi. I want to thank Stephen Sorrentino and also Jeff Goodman. I know the rabbi can be rather abrasive.
A lot, didn't he?
So but let's get through the Broadway news, first of all, because kind of a busy Broadway week, even though the economy's tanking on us. There's one thing that the economy will not affect in a negative way, I'm sure.
Good, Billy Elliot?
Billy Elliot, very good. It opened this past week at the Imperial Theater, the Elton John musicals, speaking of Elton John, booked by Lee Hall, and the reviews smash, just like the audience has been making it a smash. It got one negative review in all the reviews that I read from Time Magazine. No, no, I'm not going to read them. These are the good reviews. Listen to this. AM New York, Matt Windman says, it's the real deal, a truly compelling and absolutely spectacular theater experience designed to be a smash hit. John Simon, who I always read and take more seriously than most, gave it, almost 4 stars. He said, Billy Elliot really does have something for everyone, and that something is gloriously art. Linda Weiner of Newsday said, it's as seriously thrilling as it is deeply lovable, and Brent Brantley of The Times loved it as well. He said, it's the show, what really makes it work is that it's about the enduring appeal of musicals themselves. It isn't a dance show. It's a show about people, why people need to dance. Now, not all the news on Broadway has been so good because of the economic situation and other reasons. Well, a couple of things have announced closing, including Gypsy.
Yes.
But, I mean, Gypsy's going to be around for a while. It's not like it's closing next week or something, but I think you know why it's closing.
Well, because Patti LuPone's leaving, right?
Right. Her contract's up, and she obviously doesn't want to renew. So, despite the rave reviews, the producers called her irreplaceable. So, they're not going to be replacing her. It's going to close on March 1st, 2009. But the good news is that is the date of the opening of another classic musical. Guys and Dolls is coming back to Broadway, and it's going to be opening on March 1st at the Nederlander Theater, your rent theater.
I know.
Yay. Now, from
You know what else was surprising to the economy was Tale of Two Cities.
That surprised you.
Well, it was surprising. They came out with a date. They said they were going to close on November
16th, and they closed a week earlier.
Yeah.
It was not surprising. They were just not making the money, and they weren't expecting to make any more money, even though, as I said last week, The audience has liked it. They even loved it.
Yeah.
But the critics killed it, and if they're not going to get this new money coming in because of people, either spending their dollars elsewhere or not having
dollars. They need those Obama dollars.
Yeah, that's right. or at least the one good thing George Bush did in his presidency is every once in a while he sent people a check for no reason. It's like, it's a stimulus. Here, have some money. Unfortunately, I never was able to spend it on theater. So,
because we needed it to send on things like food and the lights.
Exactly. Want to say a couple of things about casting stuff. From The Office to All That Jazz, Melora Hardin, you may know her from the TV show The Office, and she's been doing movies for years. She's going to go in as Roxy Hart from the end of December through February, taking over for Charlotte Dambois. It is Dambois. That's the Renee Zellweger role in the movie, in case you were wondering. Also, speaking of television, Valerie Harper is going to be playing actress and tabloid queen Tallulah Bankhead in a show called Looped that's trying out in Florida at the end of December and is eyeing Broadway.
Is it at the Burt Reynolds Dinner Theater?
No. I don't have the theater. Is that even exist anymore?
I think it's gone.
Or the Jupiter? That may still be there.
Yeah, Jupiter.
They're looking at Broadway for the summer. So, and it's not a one-person show, by the way. Jared Emick from Damn Yankees.
Emick?
I'm not sure. Probably Emick. I'll defer to you on pronunciation tonight.
Sorry. Oh, my God, no. Charlie does that enough.
And a couple of, I know this woman, Liz McCann, who has produced the Tony Awards for the past few years. She's been the executive producer.
Yeah.
She's out.
Yes.
They bounced her. I'm sure just because of the ratings, because the shows have been getting better, and they do a very, very good show, but it's just the ratings have been in the toilet, and I guess they wanted to go in a different direction.
Well, they were up against the finale of The Sopranos, for God's sake.
Well, that was 2 or 3 years ago.
Well, they're always up against something horrendous.
Basketball, I know. It's tough. But their numbers are going down instead of up, so they had to do something. Now, for me, the biggest showcase of Broadway theater these days is besides the Tonys, what is it on television? What do you think it is?
I don't know.
Where does Broadway really showcase itself more than anywhere else? On commercial television.
On commercial television?
Yeah. Where do they all put the musicals out and people get to see them?
Like the talk shows and stuff like that?
Good, yeah. I mean, you could say the AM talk shows and the late... No. The Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade.
Oh, you're right.
If you think about it, that's where they really all go now. Yeah. So it's become... this year, they're going to have... I don't know if they're going to be reunited. I think they're doing separate songs, but you've got Kristen Chenoweth and Idina Menzel.
Yeah, she's doing something from... Kristen Chenoweth is doing from a new Christmas album.
Oh, yippee. And Menzel's doing something. So they'll be there together, but I don't know how together. Plus, they're going to be doing songs from White Christmas, In the Heights, South Pacific, Little Mermaid, and Hair. It's just a shame that Passing Strange never got shot. It'd be great to see them at the Thanksgiving parade. Well, as usual, we've run out of time before I can actually do any reviews. I was going to do the two Mammoth plays, but don't have time for them because we got to kind of wrap up the show. So I'm going to do a little more commercial business, then we'll be back to see our way out of the neighborhood right after this message. We've just been inside Broadway. Thanks to TotalTheater.com and Performing Arts Insider. If you have no idea what to see on Broadway this season, have I got a magazine for you. Performing Arts Insider, the Bible of Broadway and beyond. Every show is listed with enough information to make you a theater expert, just like the professionals who've relied on PAI for 64 years. Get the most recent issue at PerformingArtsInsider.com. Dave's Gone By listeners get a steep discount on subscriptions, so visit PerformingArtsInsider.com for Broadway the best way. Do you know how easy and inexpensive it is to advertise on Dave's Gone By? You don't? Well, hey, it's even easier to find out. You can run a 30 or 60-second ad or sponsor a show segment or the whole show. Just go to davesgoneby.org to see the rates. Or call 516-295-1511, 516-295-1511. Bring your message to my audience. Advertise on Dave's Gone By. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. In 2007, I created Shalom Dammit, Rabbi Saul Solomon's Peace, Love, and Acid Reflux Hour. It's a TV show by Jews, about Jews, and for everybody. It airs Wednesdays at 8 a.m. on Channel 115 and Fridays 4:30 a.m. on Channel 20. On Manhattan Cable, it's still Channel 67, Sunday afternoons, 1:30. You can also watch episodes on YouTube. Just search under my name, Saul Solomon, or Shalom Dammit. And God saw that it was good, and you'll see it's great!
Dave's Gone By. Dave's Gone By.
There goes the neighborhood.
Dave's Gone By.
There goes the
neighborhood. Just wanted to play a little bit of that. That's. Running out of time, so we're not going to even have much of a chance to pay tribute to the great Miriam Makeba, but she did pass this past week on Monday of a heart attack during a political concert on stage in Italy while she was singing her greatest hit. This is more of a modern Afro-pop version of it, but she's still great. Anyway, want to thank so much all of you for listening to Dave's Gone By every week. I want to thank our sponsors, Woodrow Delicatessen in the Peninsula Shopping Center, Hewlett Minuteman Press, where Dave's Gone By listeners get 10% off, TotalTheater.com. We've got 2,000 theater reviews now, searchable at TotalTheater.com. Please go there. It's also the gateway to DavesGoneBy.org. And Performing Arts Insider, the Bible of Broadway. Go to PerformingArtsInsider.com for more information there. And Jeff said, I don't have to say it, but I'm going to say it anyway, Fancy Schmancy Balloons for all your party decorating needs. 797-3229 is the number. Remember to watch Shalom Dammit, Rabbi Saul Solomon's Peace, Love, and Acid Reflux Hour Wednesdays at 8 in the morning on Channel 115, or Fridays at 4:30 a.m. on Channel 20 on Cablevision, or anytime on YouTube.com. Zipper.com. I want to tell everybody that the Randy Bandits are playing on Friday the 21st at the Zipper Factory on West 37th Street in Manhattan. And I just want to thank Stephen Sorrentino and Rabbi Saul Solomon. Thank you to Penny Lando at Maya Public Relations for setting all that up. I want to thank James Hodge for his input and help with making this program happen. I want to remind everybody that David G. Myers is coming up on this radio station. He's got a 10-minute show all about theater and opera and the arts. He's coming up right after this, so keep your dial right here and starting in just a couple of minutes. I want to thank my mom and dad. I want to thank my beloved and terrific wife. We had a wonderful trip that I haven't even had time to talk about to Maryland. So bless you, honey. It's just I love you more and more each week. And my good friend and my guest co-host, Jeff Goodman.
I love you more and more each week,
too. Oh, stop it. But thank you. It's time to leave the neighborhood, but I'll be back Sunday night. We will not be back next week because I'll be out of town.
Me too.
Oh, Jeff will be in Vegas. I'll be somewhere in Virginia.
Right, I'll be here.
And if my wife ever finds out I'm in Virginia, I'm in real trouble because Virginia, you know, is kind of
Virginia who?
Yeah, thank you. But we will be back Sunday night, November 30th, 2008, for the 298th episode of Dave's Gone By. So until then, don't miss your days going by. This is Dave Lefkowitz.
And Jeff Goodman.
Wishing you good night. Good Thanksgiving to those we love.
And gone by. Vasheli bonke eti longweni, Vasheli bonke kwanongong. Vasheli bonke eti longweni, Vasheli bonke kwanongong.